Today we're going to be reading a story, Who Put the Cookies in the Cookie Jar? By George Shannon, illustrated by Julie Pashkus. Okay, this is an informational text. It's nonfiction. That means it could be true. This story we're going to be reading because it gives us facts about a topic. I want you to listen as we read to see what information you can learn about maybe cookies, since we see the beginning. The picture on the front is cookies. Okay, I'm going to turn the page, and I want you to look and listen to the story as I read the story to you. Before I read, we often think about questions such as, who was in the story? What is happening? Where the story is happening? When it's happening? Or why something is happening? So let's think about those things as we read. One hand in the cookie jar takes a cookie out. How many hands put the cookie in is what the world's about. Now, what does the author mean when he says, how many hands put the cookies in? Look at all the hands putting the cookies in. What does he mean? He means that it takes more than one person to make a cookie. Maybe you've made cookies before. Maybe you had help making the cookies. Okay, look at the word in red up here. This is to make sure that the reader pays attention to this word because it's in a different color. How many hands put the cookie in is what the world's about. Let's keep reading. Hands that mix and stir the dough spoon the clumps into a row. Whose hands are making these cookies? Yes, the mom and the little girl. Okay, what do you think they're going to do next? That's right. Probably put the cookies in the oven to bake. Let's keep reading. Hands that make the cookie sheet. Here we see a man making the cookie sheet. Oven mitts against the heat. What do we use oven mitts for? Yes, to get the hot pan out of the oven. But someone has to make the oven mitts. Okay, let's keep reading. Hands that feed and milk the cow. Okay, what is the author describing here? What is that author describing? Yes, the jobs that people have to do to get the ingredients, the things that make the cookies. Okay, if you notice, the author is telling about each job and each ingredient, one after another, okay? You know you're going to need milk. You know that you're going to need grain that makes the flour. Churn the butter, okay? You have to make butter to go in the cookies. Guide the plow, okay? So the text says, milk the cow and churn the butter. So this shows a man holding milk to make butter. You have to have milk to make the butter. Okay, let's turn the page. Hands that sew and grind the wheat.
Pardon the interruption. Miss Sigmund, could you please come to the front office?
Into flour for us to eat. Okay? While I was reading the previous page, I asked myself, why was the woman plowing the field over here? I was thinking, why was she plowing that field right there? Well, on this page, I saw the man here. He's throwing seeds. That's what we call sowing seeds. Okay? And he's planting those seeds. And I think the woman was plowing the field to plant the wheat in, to plant the wheat seeds. Okay? And she was going to use that to grow the wheat, and then they'll make the flour. And flour is what cookies are made of. Let's keep reading. Hands that tend and feed the hens. What do hens give us? Yes, eggs. Gather eggs, build the pens. What is a pen? Yes, you might have, that's where they're going to live at. You have to have somewhere for them to live. See, eggs go into cookies too. So it takes people taking care of the hens. Hands that harvest sugar cane, cut and grind, load the train. Okay, what did you learn about that page? And look at this one. Here, they're loading the train. They're grinding the sugar cane. On these two pages, we learned how sugar is made and transported. How you have to cut down the plant. How you have to grind it, package it, and then send it to other places. And one way it gets to other places is the train. Let's keep reading. Hands that load the trucks and drive. How do truck drivers help make cookies? Yes, they carry all the ingredients from place to place. And the cookies, when they're made, they take them to the stores. Stock the shelves when things arrive. So these people are the store workers. They have to put the cookies or the sugar or the milk, all the ingredients, on the shelves. Sometimes we make our own cookies. Sometimes we buy cookies already made, don't we? Hands that clothe and feed them all. Heal and teach, large and small. Hands that help, the hands that help, are what the world's about. It takes all kinds of people all over the world, doesn't it, to make ingredients to go into things. Many put the cookie in so one can take it out. When it says many put the cookie in, many people had to help make all the ingredients, get the ingredients to the store, and then sell the things to us to make the cookies. But one person can take it out. And here we see all the people enjoying all of the cookies. Okay. Very good. On the next page in your book, if you look, it has ingredients for sugar cookies. It tells you the ingredients and it tells you how to make them. What do we call this? Yes, this is a recipe. It's a recipe for making sugar cookies. Maybe you can make them with your family.